So at the MEDIENTAGE in München, we're also talking about the blockchain technology and how this technology is affecting the media business. And as we just talked before, it is a really, really, really big change in the media business. So next to me, there's Alexander Shulgin, and you are not only a blockchain expert, but you invested a lot of money in the blockchain technology, and you are an investor as well with really, really visionary projects. And maybe we can just give a few examples how the blockchain technology could affect the media business. And you just gave me an example with a very, very smart example about text messaging.
First of all, of course, can you imagine if I will send you SMS text messaging, it will go through a lot of to my country, then it will come back to your country around the world, and you will receive, but you will stay closer than 1 meter. And can you imagine the big data, let's say, if I want to send a Game of Thrones, which is now 4K, but it can be 8K or 11.5K. It's huge, huge, huge amount of data just for nothing. So this is technology, decentralized technology, will allow us, like a peer-to-peer, just to communicate stronger without any third party, like a telecom, like a providers. We will be end-to-end users. And this will be, first of all, revolutionary. But during this sending, I can make access to all other creators and co-create, and they can add to my content also. And their rights will be absolutely copyright, and the nano payments, which is allowed by blockchain technology, will distribute it to this co-creator if I wish.
So instead of sending the whole data through the internet, through a third party provider, through a controlled instance to a centralized system, you're granting me access to your mobile phone to read the message, or you're granting me access as a consumer to your data without any middleman.
Yes, if it's a content, I can give you access to my content. So I will not distribute this content. So you don't need to distribute the song or video or film, or you just give access. So this is new format which is created by blockchain media. It's re-evolutionary, because before the time in the analog, you remember this term called master tape. And then this master tape will have a value. In the digital world, there is unlimited quantity of the copies that's why piracies came also. But if you will make only one unit, it will be a master. So it's, first of all, it became a value. It's a good for valuation of the media content producer companies, valuation of the library. The second is it will stop any piracy. And then you will have all your data, all access of your data, because you control your content, not through the third parties.
And the business model could change from subscription models, where I pay my €9 or $10 a month for the access to a library of Spotify or Apple Music, by nano payments, right?
Yes, by you can pay whatever you listen, because now the model is you can subscribe for unlimited song, let's say Spotify. But if I don't need unlimited song, if you just need one song or the half of the song, the chorus, you can't subscribe, because you cannot process the payment with any credit card or any other wallet. But with blockchain, you can pay 0.001 cents, and you can pay exactly for the part of what you listen or what you watch.
But then we're talking about long-term business models with very, very small amount of money, nano payments, and not the big money for one piece.
But very important is that the old model of monetization will be changed, and then will be not the pay for content, it will be data mining. So the old data around the content can be sold or can be monetized. So it's a change completely, a model of ecosystem of around the content ecosystem. Yes.
So a revolutionary technology, a dramatic change for the media business. Thanks, Alexander Shulgin. Thanks for being my guest.
Ja, vielen Dank.
Bitteschön.